Hi friends, welcome to Rahagir India Students Adda, your most trusted channel for defense related information. Friends, today I'm going to tell you about the news which is like a revolution for the Indian Armed Forces. Yes friends, I'm going to talk about the cadre restructuring of the Indian Army, in which the Indian Army is going to start of a new cadre which is going to be from the SSB failed candidates. Those candidates who missed the SSB narrowly will be given a chance to become the direct commissioned JCOs, and these JCOs will thereafter serve as lieutenant colonels in the armed forces. Looking at the history of this historic decision, gentlemen, the last cadre restructuring of Indian Army was done 35 years ago. That was in 1984. Thereafter, after the Kargil War, a mini restructuring was done in which the AV Singh committee was formed and it gave its own recommendations for some changes in the Indian Armed Forces. Although there were some changes in which the age of COs was reduced, the lieutenant colonel rank was given at a fixed tenure of 13 years. However, it didn't change the actual overall cadre structure of the army. The present proposals are going to completely change that. The aim of this cadre restructuring will be cutting down truth to tail ratio. Gentlemen, you are aware that with the upgradation of military infrastructure in the border areas, there are various facilities which can be made use of, like the petroleum depots are there at the very, very forward locations, and Indian Oil Corporation can provide or has promised to provide the petroleum till the border areas. So therefore, we can use these type of infrastructure to cut down our administrative setup or administrative units which are there in the army. You will be surprised to know that we have almost equal number of administrative units as we have the fighting units. So there is a requirement to reduce these administrative units. Secondly though, friends, there is a lot of shortage of officers at the lower ranks. At the higher ranks, the officers are enough. The promotion avenues are very low for these officers at the higher ranks. However, at the lower ranks, there is a lot of shortage of officers. So this step will reduce the shortage of these officers to a large extent. The most important proposal of this cadre restructuring is the start of new cadre of officers, which will be commissioned from the SSB failures. The SSB failures will be given a choice to get commissioned as direct commissioned JCOs. They will serve for 30 years and retire as lieutenant colonels. To understand this system, let's go back into the background. Friends, as you are all aware, the Indian Army was born through the British Indian Army. The Britishers owed, or the British officers owed their loyalties to the British Crown. However, they found the soldiers who were natives needed someone to control them. So they upgraded certain officers or certain people to rank of junior commissioned officers or JCOs. These were people from the natives but were not given the rank of actual officers. These junior leaders were required to lead them in the field. At that time, the authority and powers of these junior commissioned officers was not laid down. They were employed as per the whims and fancies of their British officers. The Indian Army continued the same system even after 1947 and more or less is continuing in the same fashion till date. Friends, if you look at the present system of Indian ranks, especially in the Jawans, a Jawan comes as the rank of Sipoy. From Sipoy, he becomes Nayak, Hawaldar, Naib Subedar, Subedar, and few become to Subedar Major. At the time of retirement, few of these people are given honorary ranks like honorary lieutenant and honorary captains. The direct commission to the rank of JCOs is not there and is there only in very, very few posts like religious teacher and catering JCOs. These people also do not get opportunity to become officers. Therefore, the new system will be a very different system and will provide the opportunities for the JCOs to become the officers. Friends, when this new proposal was mooted, there was a certain queries that why not strengthen the present system of JCOs instead of starting a new cadre. So gentlemen, it was analyzed and certain few problems were found in the present system of JCOs. As you look, a JCO who has come or become now, he has come from his ranks. So he has put in almost 20-25 years of service, and he is at an age when he is not so much agile. He does not have that much initiative which is required in a young officer. Secondly, our jawans come from a very humble background, especially with respect to education. Earlier, even 8th pass used to get commissioned into the fighting arms. So when these people grow up and become JCOs, their education levels do not change much, and hence they do not have the education and intelligence which is required in a younger officer. Also, these people are given very limited opportunities in the initial years of their training and service because they are as jawans. So once they become seniors, their limited exposure precludes them from doing the duties of the officers. Now friends, let's have a look at the highlights of the proposed system. In the proposed system, gentlemen, the entrance exam like SSB, it will be same like the present officers. Like you go for CDS entrance exam, the same entrance exam will be there, and all those who clear this exam will be called for the SSB. At the SSB will also be similar. Like at present, it is 5 days SSB, later on it might be 3 days de novo SSB. So the SSB will be the same what is being done for all regular officers. The only change comes hereafter. So all those candidates who miss out narrowly in the SSB, say between 5% to 10% of the passing marks, they will be given an option. In that option, if someone exercises that option, he will be selected to the direct commissioned JCO cadre. Thereafter, the enrollment and the medical will be same as that of the regular officers. These will get commissioned and go to the units as junior commissioned officers. These people, gentlemen, will go to one of the training academies. It might be OTA Gaya or some suitable academy might be earmarked for the training of these people. The routine and the training of these new cadre will be same which is being followed for the present regular officer cadre. Thereafter, almost for the 9 months or the 12 months of the training, these people will be commissioned in the units and will be given 6 months on the job training where they will learn about the jobs which they are going to perform. They will also undergo various training courses like the young officer course which are applicable to the regular officers. If we look at the promotion and service norms of these officers, gentlemen, they will be enrolled at the rank of Naib Subedar. They will be granted time scale promotion after every 5 years. So, after 5 years, they will become Subedar. After 10 years, they will be Subedar Major. And after 15 years, they will be commissioned as Lieutenant. So, these people will become Lieutenant after 15 years of service. Thereafter, they will continue for another 15 years and will retire after 30 years of service. And the rank at the retirement will be that of Lieutenant Colonel. If we look at the numbers, gentlemen, the aim will be to overcome the shortage of young officers. Therefore, this cadre, including the ASS cadre, will form almost 50% of the young officer's strength. This will help in overcoming the shortage of the juniors or the junior officers in the units. The ORs, gentlemen, who come as the normal jawans, they will also have a chance to get inducted into the JCO cadre and will have to go through the written and SSB, similar to the present system of where the special commissioned officers have to undergo. Since this system is already in open, it will be part of your written exams, or some questions may be asked to you in your SSB interview. So gentlemen, let's analyze this proposal. The major issue this proposal is going to address is the availability of young officers in the unit. At present, there are very few officers in the units, and which affects the operational efficiency of these units. Also, this will provide a better promotional aspects for the regular officers. Since the most of the officers will be from this cadre, almost 50% will be from this cadre, the other 50% cadre of regular officers, they will have better promotional aspects or better promotional avenues. There is going to be more competition at lower levels because there are more officers, more number of young officers, and there will be always be competition between direct commission regular officer and direct commission JCO officer. There might be some issues like the promotion is only up to lieutenant colonel rank, and this may discourage many people from opting for this cadre. Also, the existing JCO cadre which is already there in the units, they also might feel sidelined because they will not get those many tasks which they are getting now. And also, there might be some friction between this cadre officers and the officers who are coming by a regular entry. And secondly, or the last thing is the dilution of intake standards. Since the SSB failed candidates are going to be taken in, the lowering of standards may not be good for the overall health of the army. Despite all this, friends, if we look at this proposal, is going to be a very good proposal, a earth-shattering proposal for the candidates who miss out on the SSB. Generally, many armies, including the US, they follow the direct system of recruitment. So we are no different from them, and we can also have the similar system. Even in CRPF, there is a grade B cadre which supplies officers for the regular officers. So because of this, the promotional aspects for the regular officers become more. Presently, gentlemen, the promotional aspects are very low, and restructuring is the duty or the need of the hour, gentlemen. However, the government needs to make sure that the lateral entry of these people or the regular officers, if they want to go, or the short service commissioned officers, if they want to go in the civil services, is ensured and its implementation is done in the right earnest. Finally, this might increase the selection percentage in SSB and may bring cheers to many SSB candidates. Gentlemen, this is important. Please share it with other friends, pass it to others, and provide me your comments. Thanks for watching. Continue subscribing to this channel. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.